chemistry between people is more than just a turn of phrase. And recent research may be leading to some new insights into the most mysterious of human feelings, love. One study is investigating how the mind produces those tender, passionate moments, even in rodents.
They're pretty cute in their own way. They can bite, but you have to be amazed by the level of their social behavior, the fact that they will form these long-term relationships and that they are so incredibly faithful. That by itself is remarkable.
Dr. Tom Insel is fascinated by the brain of an affectionate, unassuming little creature called a prairie vole, which is one of the few mammals that mates for life.
They go through a remarkable life change at the time that they mate. Thereafter, both the male and female show these profound behavioral differences. The female shows a lifelong preference for the mate that she's just spent time with. Now, the question has become then, what is happening in the brain that goes with this personality change? What's taking place in the brain?
To find out, Dr. Insel began to observe the dating habits of the female vole. She checks out the first male, whom she's never met. She's not impressed. But when she reaches the other male, with whom she's mated, it's clear she's found her sweetheart. When Insel examined the vole's brains, he discovered that two substances were released when they mated, called oxytocin and vasopressin. They are neurotransmitters, the chemicals that carry messages along the neural networks. These two are made in a part of the brain called the hypothalamus, which is connected to virtually every other part of the brain. The hypothalamus is the source of some of our most basic instincts, including desire.
They turn on circuits that are important for reinforcement. From the animal's perspective, they want more and more of what they've just experienced. What we're calling social attachment, in some way, is the craving for being with the mate with whom they've experienced this very special neurochemical moment.
Do people, too, become addicted to love?
We do know that the human brain has oxytocin and vasopressin. We know as well that those hormones are released with mating in humans.
Does Insel think love is just biochemistry?
For me, the biology in no way detracts from the romance of love. For me, the biology makes it more mysterious, more awesome, more powerful, in fact.